Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is a very important message about a very serious matter that is affecting our community and could have a drastic impact on our community. So I hope you're able to watch this and share it with other members of MCC. Unfortunately, a lot of people have been parking in the areas around MCC to attend Jumu'ah, and now that has led to the possibility of MCC losing their operational permit. And this will have drastic impact on the community and impact everybody from the youngest children to the oldest members of the community coming to the MCC center. One of the main reasons why this issue is happening is that MCC only has 120 parking spaces and about 350 people who come to the Jumu'ah, the first Jumu'ah. Now, most people don't carpool, so what happens is that people start parking in the other areas, in the Boeing parking lot, in the Zoho parking lot, in the HP parking lot, and in a nearby apartment complex. And I want to take a few moments for myself, I'll start with advising myself, and for those of you watching, to share with other people about what Islam really means and what our deen really means. We have to, as Muslims, we have to look at our deen holistically. We have to look at it holistically. We can't have a myopic view of what we do as Muslims and how we practice. And I'll explain what I mean by that. What I mean by that is that when we engage in an act of worship, we feel that it's between us and Allah. And that's true. The act of worship is between us and Allah. No intermediary. But what we often fail to remember is that we live within a community of other human beings, of other creatures, of inanimate objects, and we have to interact with those, with everything around us. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us this. And he taught us the etiquette of how to approach the masjid, in that when we want to go to the mosque to commune with our Lord and to have that personal one-on-one connection and create that connection, he taught us how to think about the people around us. So what are some of the things that he taught us to think about? He taught us that if in the process of our worship, this is the important part, if in the process of our worship, it affects our interactions with other people. So here's the two things. Worship between us and Allah, ibadah, and our mu'amala. If the worship affects the mu'amala with other people, what takes precedence? What do we give precedence to? We give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His infinite justice and mercy and generosity, His karam, He has given precedence to the interaction. So for example, if somebody else has water and I don't have water, I cannot take that person's water without his or her permission. You see how that's working? My act of worship of needing to do will do, but the right that this other person has in owning that water, who gets precedence? They do. And so if we go to the masjid, and in the process of going to the masjid, we take somebody else's haq, or the only way for us to go to the masjid is by taking somebody else's right, somebody's haq, that person's right takes precedence over our right to have a personal worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some practical ways that comes up, and the scholars have mentioned that in the books of fiqh. If a person eats garlic or onions and has bad breath, it is haram for them to go to the masjid, even for Jumu'ah, until they can remove that breath from the bad breath, the remains and the traces of that. Subhanallah, look at that. The mercy of our Sharia is thinking about the worship of other people. Nobody wants to smell bad breath. They don't want to smell BO. If they specifically mention this, if a person has bad body odor, it's haram for them to go to the masjid, because while you're sitting there and focused and making this communication with your Lord, you're hurting other people. And so it becomes haram to go to the masjid. Now, we're talking about garlic. We're talking about onions. Think about when you park the car in somebody else's parking lot. Don't think, oh, I'm doing something wajib. No, you're doing something haram to be able to do something that's an act of worship, which now makes it two harams, because you have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in taking this other person's right, and you have worshipped Allah through disobedience. And so if a person is not able to make it to the Jumu'ah and find one of the parking spaces that is designated, that is the haq of MCC, you cannot take the haq of somebody else. So let's make that clear. If you park in somebody else's parking lot, not only is it illegal, not only is it bad manners, not only is it unethical, it is haram, unequivocally. There is no shubha, no fatwa out there, no difference of opinion. If you take the haq of somebody else, you have done a sin, you have to make tawbah, and this process will continue in that it continues to be haram until you stop it. So we are asking you, if you are parking in other people's parking spots, stop, because now you are taking, what happens if MCC gets shut down? All the programs for the little children, the people who are bringing their children to the masjid, that will stop. The people who are taking their shahada at the masjid, that will stop. The people who want to pray with Allah. So now not only are you taking the right of other people at Zoho, at Boeing, at the apartment complex, you're taking the haq, the right of every single person. So this is what everybody needs to do. Park in the designated parking spot. If you can't find a parking spot, go to the second Jumu'ah. If you can't go to the second Jumu'ah, go to another Jumu'ah. And here's the kicker. If you can't find a parking spot at the first Jumu'ah and you can't make it to the second Jumu'ah, pray Dhuhr. Pray Dhuhr. Pray Dhuhr. Pray Dhuhr and do not do something haram to come to the first Jumu'ah. What you can do as an individual, if you see somebody else parking in, take the initiative to go up to that person and tell them, brother, you are not only doing something haram by taking the haq, the right of this other person, you are now taking the right of the entire MCC community, everybody that has a right to that spot. You need to go back. You need to go back. And so everybody in the community, if you're not doing it yourself, if you're parking properly, or if you're going to another masjid, or if you're going to the second Jumu'ah, jazakum Allahu khairan. But now what we're asking you is to be part of the neighborhood patrol, because now we have people who are parking in other people's parking areas and making it a mess for everybody else. So we're going to stop this, because we are not going to lose MCC's privilege to operate in the community. We are going to stop everybody from doing this, and we need everybody's help. Thank you for listening. I know it's been a long video. 7 minutes in this day and age is very long, but this is an important and very critical matter. We need everybody's help. If you're parking in somebody else's parking lot, don't do it. Stop. It is haram. If you see somebody else's parking in there, stop them, because the Prophet ﷺ said, if one of you sees something wrong, stop it with your hand, with your tongue, with your heart. Stop it with your tongue. Tell them what you're doing is wrong. Send them back. For the volunteers, jazakum Allahu khair. Send everybody back. And don't feel bad. You are not stopping the people from coming to the house of Allah. You are stopping the people who are going to close the doors of the house of Allah. So don't be a person who closes the doors of the house of Allah. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.